Hello, hello. There we go. Howdy. I've got like 35 seconds until it starts, but I'm gonna go here for 1 second because they're doing one of their like dance game commercials, which, oh gosh, this is gonna be great. Anyway, how you doing, Pepper? Hope you're having a good day. They're dancing, they're having fun. Please stop dancing at least for a moment. I don't want to start the video off with just pain. Pain in the sense of music. Slight headache, but you're doing all right. Oof. No, I've also got a little headache. We'll be in it together. But yeah, get some water. If you need rest, please also do that. I don't know. It could be from a number of things. Headaches are annoying. I probably just need to hydrate. But yeah, hopefully yours isn't anything serious either. Okay, it is time. It transitioned into the actual thing. I should have known they'd do something goofy like this. So I think I might have cropped off. My bad? Yes.
Bottom here.
We'll make it work. Don't worry. Okay. Right. That's the end of what? Interesting. Oh, I see. That's fine. All right. And then we just bonk and. That'll be fine, probably. Whoop. And center. Beautiful. Yeah, this is absolutely gonna be great. I shouldn't be surprised. This is kind of why I wanted to watch the Ubisoft one, just for the funny stuff, and also there's probably gonna be a ton of, like, copyright junk. Why do I worry so much about that? It doesn't even matter. Not even like I have monetization. Yeah, whatever. They're dancing! Congrats to the finalists of Just Dance Tournament? Interesting, there was a Olympics licensed event. Okay. Well, good for them, I guess. Ah, yeah. They're Just Dance. So much stuff. You know, back in college, I used to have a couple of those on like a YouTube playlist that I would just dance to. Just because I needed to like move. I should probably do something similar nowadays, but shh, it's fine. Anyway, it's Ubisoft time. Got cereal again, and hopefully this time I will not choke on milk. Oh, it's time. Blue people. Mix of gameplay, cutscenes, and in-engine footage. It says. Roar! Quality that I've got to set on. The RDA's greed poisoned our world. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know what? I'm sorry we skipped like a second. It'll be fine. Me.
I was trained in their ways, their technology, their weapons, things that a Na'vi should not know.
I mean, one day, you say that as if Na'vi don't know war. Oh no, and it was so exciting too. I know, right? Listen, I didn't hate the movie. Back in the day, I kind of liked it. I haven't seen the new one though, and like, makes him like, oh man, these people are so peaceful, but like. They were tearing people apart. I guess it's more like a, active whatever versus like, we are peaceful, but if war is necessary, it's stupid. But like, yeah. Oh boy, we can parkour the yellow vines.
Free to decide who I was going to be.
We dead.
Free to discover what I was meant to do.
Now you see what they kept you from.
Free to discover what she was meant to do, which is to say the hair sex. Whatever. Such a weird, weird movie.
Now Pandora is under attack again.
Don't let the Na'vi get in our way. Get rid of them.
And I have a choice to make. I choose to protect my home.
Okay. Wow.
I was a child of two worlds.
Human bad, blue alien good, yeah. That's really the gist of it, isn't it? They are Na'vi. From Tears of Pandora. Sure. Rise to the challenge.
Hi there, everyone. I'm Jim Cameron, the creator of
Jim Cameron.
Avatar, the Way of Water.
Is that how he likes to be referred to? If so, interesting.
I set out to imagine another world, a world as rich and complex as our own, and we wanted the audience to feel
old Jimmy Cameron. Yeah.
To dream with their.
That's interesting, because it literally said, you know, this is James Cameron on the side. But like, does he want to be Jim? It's fine if he does. It's just. Hilarious that, like, we insist on saying James Cameron.
To immerse people in this world. Our friends at Ubisoft share the same ambition, and the team at Mass.
Unless he's just trying to, like, endear himself to us, in which case that's kind of weird. I'm okay with being, like, a distant person.
Frontiers of Pandora, our creative team at Lightstorm has been able to share their insights with Massive's talented team, who are experts in creating
Massive
open worlds. Together, we'll be able to bring players to the Western Frontier with new environments, new flora and fauna, new characters, and an original story that coexists with the events of the Avatar films.
A new story that seems almost identical to the movie.
To the world of Avatar once again.
Except in this time, instead of doing like the mind meld thingy, it's just they kidnap Na'vi. Cool, great. Yay! The smiles on their faces. They're trying.
My name is Dita Dainfeld, and as the game director, I'm proud to be representing the team behind Avatar Frontiers of Pandora today, and excited to share a sneak peek of what we've been working on. In this all-new story, you'll set out on a journey of discovery to unravel the mysteries of your past, learn what it means to be Na'vi, and explore new parts of Pandora on land or together with your trusted Banshee in the air.
I was going to say, in the sea?
Create a playground where curiosity is rewarded. This tangible and highly immersive first experience.
Yes. Some whole new ground for Ubisoft. Open world RPG.
Superhuman strength and your natural to gain the upper hand. As the Na'vi say, Sivako, let's rise to the challenge on December 7th. Until then,
pre-order now on Ubisoft Store. Wow.
Beauty and the danger of the Western frontier.
I was about to say, are we getting, like, a second trailer for it? But there'll be audio logs and map towers, too. Never seen those before. Oh, yeah. The trees are probably gonna be, like, the towers. And there's gonna be, obviously, audio logs. I think, yeah, very unique concept. Definitely not going to be like every other Ubisoft game at this point.
I'm Didi Dienfeld, game director, and I'm excited to reveal what's
Rawr.
For you on Pandora. The story of our game begins when the RDA expands their operations to the Western Frontier.
We just went over this, though.
The leaders of the RDA abduct you and other Na'vi children from your home.
Cool.
Teach you the ways of humans, hoping to mold you and turn you against your own people. But his plan is interrupted by the Battle of the Hallelujah Mountains, and you are put into emergency cryosleep. When you awaken, 15
okay.
years later, you are a stranger in your birthplace. Knowing the dangers posed by the RDA, you set out to take them down and look to secure the help of other Na'vi clans. Initially, you're as an outsider, so you have to reconnect with your lost Na'vi heritage to gain their trust. On your adventure, you'll find your own path as you discover what it means to be Na'vi.
I guess. I was gonna say, like, do they even know their mother tongue, so to speak? But I suppose, I mean, they were kids, so they probably had a little bit of it, and then just a really rough go of trying to remember it again. Wow, so peaceful.
Okay, we'll show you the way to the rookery, where you can bond for life with your very own Ikram. The Ikram is a devoted companion that you can name, feed, and customize. Experiment with acrobatics.
Oh boy, you can customize them. Yeah, but can I give them different saddles like Zelda?
From the air.
Open world.
You'll get to the upper plains. An expansive grassland filled with contrasts and open views as far as the eye can see.
I mean, it looks pretty.
Sesquatlan live here in symbiosis with gigantic beasts called Sakru. Earn the clan's trust, and they will teach you the art of riding dire horses.
And I won't earn their trust. I'll just
clouded forest. We're hidden in the mist.
Still, no. That would be awful.
Here lives the Kamatiri, a clan of healers with their own dark reasons to stay hidden.
Dark reasons?
RDA operations are threatening the balance of Pandora.
Is there stuff to do other than writing stuff? No, it's an open world game, don't you know? Exploration is the main thing. And also walking around with an arrow in your hand.
Multiple combat styles.
Your wow.
Instincts allow you to get an overview of the battlefield, mark your enemies.
A child of two worlds. Don't make it sound so mysterious. They were kidnapped and trained as child soldiers.
Or the staff sling to set up traps. For a more explosive approach, you can leverage your human training and go for the blast of an assault rifle, a shotgun, or go bigger with the occasional rocket launcher.
The occasional- don't stand that close to it. I've got like Link PTSD for like explosions that close.
Will help you in aerial combat against the RDA. Destroying RDA facilities will have a-
you know, you'd think that like by now anyone trying to like attack Pandora would be like, no, we gotta make this stuff like arrow proof, you know? Oh boy, meal making.
What it truly means to become Na'vi.
Just like Zelda for real, for real.
By connecting to Awa through the Tarshu plant and learn from the memories of your ancestors. Skill upgrades can improve many aspects of your
spicy,
such as your natural agility to move through the world, your stealth approach to hunting and fighting,
or the- How you're doing, Wookie? Konnichiwa wa 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 to you too.
Avatar, Frontiers of Pandora is a
you haven't missed much. It's all been Avatar.
Maximize the power of new gen consoles and
PC. This is Avatar, the game, and then the blue people. And then, they had like a Just Dance thing. Not Just Dance. Yeah, Just Dance, at the very start. Yeah, Ubisoft open world game, but with Avatar skin. Indeed. They're spending a lot of time on this. I guess because it's a giant property, like IP. But like, Ubisoft, it's okay. You don't have to spend 20 minutes on a game. I really just need, like, concise trailers. I'm okay with that. Frontiers of Pandora, December 7th. Short and simple. So short and simple. Oh, let's go. This is how we talk when we're playing games, right? These are actual, like, pro gamers, I think, though. Multi-kill. That'd be a lot. I'm serious, Ubisoft, so which one? Oh gosh, no, not the Reinhardt shields! Epic killstreak, my team, bro! Yeah. And similar, your kind of trailers, yeah. They had the Reinhardt and the monkey shields. How dare. Listen, I call everything, like, in, whatchamacallit, Overwatch terms, just because that's, like, the only, like, game that I play of this variety. I'm sure other games have shields, obviously. But they're always Reinhardt to me. Wow, sick, I scored a draw.
Hello, everyone.
For what? Who knows?
Hello, hello. My name is Mark Rubin, executive producer on X Defiant. What you just saw was a collection of live clips and reactions from players streaming our game during our closed beta test in April. And we've been absolutely overwhelmed by the amazing response to our game from players all over the world. Now, for us, community has really been the core.
So cool, so pog, bro.
And we've had 28
X Defiant.
With the recent closed beta being the largest, and of course, the first with no NDA. And throughout all of these tests, we've done our best
NDAs.
To listen and respond.
PogChamp, as the kids say. Oh yeah, that's how it goes, right? That's the current way to say it.
And the countless creators and streamers who shared their footage and feedback about X Defiant. Now we're ready to look towards the future. We are currently planning launching later this summer. But before we do that, we will be holding another test to address some of the feedback from the closed beta. This open session will be available to everyone on PC, PS5,
oh boy.
Xbox Series,
time to get
S.
murdered by everyone playing that game. No.
A short test, but we are opening it to everyone.
2 days.
Back as possible
like a an open beta, that's kind of normal.
To stress out the servers as much as possible.
Yeah.
If you have not played X Defiant yet, this is your chance. But let's talk.
I say it's sure, but that's like. It's like a splatfest, you know?
We will start with a 6-week preseason that will have all of our launch content with 14 maps, 5 factions, 20 weapons, and much, much more.
Preseason. We got our roadmaps, y'all.
Content schedule, which is packed with some really exciting content. With 4 brand new meta-changing factions. Each
meta-changing factions.
12 new weapons.
I'll be the Neon X. Everyone else can be the Tech X.
Inspired by Ubisoft's amazing worlds. I think
oh boy.
Be surprised at where we
inspired
go.
By Ubisoft worlds.
Year 1
is
really going to have a lot of great gameplay content. All focused on creating a fun arcade FPS experience. And we are committed to staying.
They're like, we know Overwatch is failing, so let's make our own.
The best place to compete and have fun. Now, it's been quite
with blackjack and hookers.
So thank you again to all of the players that supported X Defiant so far. And for everyone who hasn't
Thank you.
Had a chance, we hope to see you in game soon. Thank you.
Oh, Prince of Persia, I think. I think. Or maybe this is something else. I don't remember if Prince of Persia is a Ubisoft IP. Oh no! He's dead. He's dead again! The ankle stab! Oh no! Whew! Felt that sneeze coming, I was like, oh gosh, I'm chewing food, please! Thank you. More drama than this trailer. I'm kidding. He's dying a lot. Oof. Oh boy. This is the Chimera. Chimera. Yeah, it's a chimera. Hey, okay. Good, I didn't forget. The chimichanga, exactly. January 18th.
It's so exciting to be with you today. About 30 years ago, in 1989, I discovered a great action-adventure game, both challenging my skills and respecting my cleverness. It was Prince of Persia. I am Muni Radi,
oh boy.
Game director of Prince of Persia, The Lost Crown. Time has come.
It's gonna be 8-bit again. No.
Legendary Persia. In an era,
it was like not even 8-bit. No, maybe it was. It was just very simple, a bit.
Of a squad of 7 elite warriors, the Immortals. One night, Prince Hassan, sole heir to the throne, is abducted and taken to a hostile and cursed land, Mount Kaf. You and your brothers in arms are sent on a rescue mission to save Prince Hassan. However, this assignment will cast you straight into the lion's den. And it is here that you, Sargon, and the whole kingdom must prepare to face the greatest threat of your lives. This is your story. In Mount Kaf, your destiny awaits.
I wonder if it's going to be anything like the original, if that's probably just nostalgia bait. I think that was just nostalgia bait because he was talking about, like, I found this game back in the day. So I think it was just like a representation of, like, look, this is what it looked like then, and this is what it looks like now. Look how much better the graphics are. Kind of thing. I kind of doubt they'd go with, like, an 8-bit skin for this game. I don't see Ubisoft doing something like that. Nintendo, on the other hand, oh, probably. I mean, they've already done it with, like, Mario Odyssey. They did, like, those little segments of 8-bit and stuff. And in other words, nothing like the original WoW. Yeah. I say as if I know. I never played a Prince of Persia game, but I know. I think I might have, like, one of my cousins might have had it at one point, and I might have seen, like, a little bit, but, like, yeah. I really don't know much. They're reimagining it. Wow.
Some dwellers are willing to help you, while others are more reluctant.
At least it isn't just another open world RPG. It's a 2D.
But Sargon is a swordsman like
action game. But yeah.
He is a fierce warrior, known for being elusive, ruthless, and extremely skillful on the battlefield.
He's known for being ruthless. Finish him!
He constantly puts his life on the line to perform the devastating attack.
Got so many finishers. No! He's dead again. Ow. Oh, ow.
Time powers are back. But this time...
Oh, sands of time. Like it worked last time. One of the last times. We'll just bring it back, right? Interesting.
By combining all these skills together, you can express your creativity.
Cool. Please connect back to my chat, please. I always panic when I see that little loading thingy at the bottom of chat. I want to say I know anything about other races' hairstyles, but the hair looks kind of out of place in the apparent time period. Mayhaps. I think Ubisoft, I think, tends to go more for flair than accuracy. I'll just put it that way. But yeah. I won't say too much, but I don't know if a lot of people back in Zeday had dreads like that. Looks cool though.
I'd like to thank Mentrix, who composed the in-game music you are just listening to. And of course, my fantastic team at Ubisoft.
Oh yeah, get it on Nintendo Switch. The best place to get it.
For you to get your hands on the game. It releases on January 18, 2024 on all platforms. Thank you and enjoy the rest of the show.
Captain Laser Fox. Blood Dragon. Wait, this is... Blood Dragon was a... whatchamacallit? Oh, wait, no. It's got the gamer glasses.
Hi. My name is Adi Shankar. I'm a TV and movie producer. You may know me from the Castlevania animated series on Netflix.
Oh, congrats.
Or one of my fanfiction shorts on YouTube. Seven years ago, I got a call from Ubisoft offering me the opportunity to adapt...
Yeah, Blood Dragon was a Far Cry thing, I think.
...very serious franchises into an anime. But instead, I came back to them with a crazy concept inspired by the mood of Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean...
This concept used Ubisoft's...
Blood Dragon was wild.
...library of characters and remixed them into one delirious anime series that would become this love letter to the 90s. Or at least how I remember the 90s. And to my absolute surprise, Ubisoft said no.
But then, I made Castlevania, and they're like, okay, we gotta get this guy.
Just kidding. They said yes. That's why I'm up here. Come on.
All right. No need to get angry.
This is the story of how the first anime series by Ubisoft was born. Captain Lake.
Story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down.
This show is many things. It's violent. It's a dystopian fiction in the spirit of the works of Aldous Huxley. It's a spoof. It's a satire. It's dark comedy. It's a love story. And as a descendant of Indian mystics, yeah, I can tell you it's the most philosophically conscious show.
Can't we just put all the genres in there? I mean, if they can make it work, sure.
The series was picked up by Netflix.
but genius picked up by Netflix, maybe not the most
and today, I'm very happy to
stellar thing nowadays.
which may happen. It will be
released
worldwide later this year.
At least got some like stage presence on like some of the some presenters on these things. I mean, to be fair, you don't need to have stage presence to be a like game director.
Easter egg filled teaser trailer right now.
All right, dude. You know, we all need the gamer glasses. Your world. YouTube video bait. Oh yeah. Just got remixed. Oh my gosh, it's the Rangers, the booty. Oh, Rabbids. Oh yeah, you want your Assassin's Creed frog, right? Right? How's the forward? It's Ubisoft. they've talked about didn't know this is even going on. Yeah, I kind of like keeping up on this kind of stuff just for the heck of it. But yeah, they talked about Avatar the Blue People. They have a game. It's very Ubisoft. Prince of Persia. They also did a little bit of, and then that was an anime about Far Cry Blood Dragon, but it's like just a whole bunch of remix stuff. So goofy, so quirky, very Ubisoft. I don't know. I just like ragging on Ubisoft. They make goofy stuff. More excited for the Xbox. The Xbox One was yesterday, so if you do want to watch it, it's up and around. Had some interesting stuff. I think a lot of it was more like stuff that I already kind of knew, but yeah. And there's a Capcom one in a bit. Frogwear Assassin outfit, I clap! I'm excited for Fable. Nice, nice, nice. Yeah. There's a lot of stuff that, like, I don't or haven't played, but I'm sure there's a lot of people that are excited about it. Yeah. It was already announced earlier, but there's all that, like, Persona stuff. Yelled so hard during a voice call chat. Nice. I'm glad you're excited about it. It's fun to be excited about games, you know? Tom Clancy, so many Persona 3. Yeah, I saw that, like, it's a remake of the original, so there isn't, like, the female protagonist kind of thing, which kind of made some people like, just kind of a bummer. But who knows? Maybe. Mayhap still. Yeah. Imagine making a new Persona. They will. There will be a Persona 6, I have no doubt. They just wanna... Yeah. Female main character shafted again, exactly. Such a shame. In the next one, they better have a female main character. And just make it, like, base game. Come on, do it, you cowards! Milk the Persona 5 cow until it dies. I mean, it made them bang. And I don't mind some spin-offs. They've done spin-offs of, like, even 4 as well. They did a whole bunch of, like, the dancing games and stuff. So yeah, I'm not surprised, but also... At some point, they gotta, right? Nothing made for them, 4 was their previous cow. Yeah, exactly. And then 3 to a slightly lesser extent. I think 4 really, like, extra exploded for them. And then 5 just kind of built on that. I mean, I am impressed that people can sing this deep, gosh dang. This Assassin's Creed Captain- Oh no, there was a different pirate game that they made, or are making, I think. If I recall right. Was he? Oh, he's making that drum sound. think. I was like, why are they focusing on him? What is he saying? Because for some reason it makes your brain feel awful things. Oh no! Yeah, that dude's making the percussion sounds weird. Not weird, that's a thing that people can do. Yo ho ho, you are a pirate! I feel like this, if I recall it from other people talking, this one seems to take a lot from like the Assassin's Creed, the pirate one, Black Flag, I think. But it's a separate game, not tied to Assassin's Creed. So they were like, huh, we hear that people like pirate stuff. Let's make one. Yo ho! I don't know. At least Ubisoft tries to make it still like a entertainment thing, but it's just so goofy. I don't know, they've always had like these musical segments and stuff. Even when it was E3. Interesting, one of them isn't wearing their ear things. Why aren't you wearing your ear things, my guy? Yeah, Skull and Bones. Ubisoft original, they probably just like exported, not exported, but they probably got a lot of like the stuff from the Black Flag. To at least advise on that. Oh no. Long live piracy, eh? Yeah, a bold statement from a big game company. For honor. Y7S2, season 2, year 7? Has For Honor been out that long? Oh yeah, Rabbids. New DLC. Cute, cute. Oh no! Yet another, Yu-Gi-Oh! That's a radio, but they were just characters in something. Another cute rabbit, yeah. Unfortunately, they were stars in a different game. I wish that I could go back and look at that. It's like, what game was it? I was excited too for Jet Set Radio. There's a different game that has like the Jet Set Radio vibe. What is it called again? I don't think it's Ubisoft though. Let's see here. Game. Bomb Rush Cyberpunk. I think it's a Microsoft game. Yeah, it looks good. That's one that I kind of want to play. Alright, have a good lurk, son! Wow, they're actually bringing Rayman in. Why? Okay. I'm stunned. Stunned into silence. I'm kidding. I also initial release date 2017. Oh gosh. Yeah, that will be going on 7 years. My Team Reptile is an indie game, apparently. Nice, nice, nice. Maybe it was just saying that it would be on, like, a, like, Game Pass. It's probably all that actually was. Which, I'm not surprised everything's on Game Pass. But yeah, I think it's coming to, like, everything. Because I don't want it on Xbox. I don't have an Xbox. Yeah, I'm excited for that game. Oh boy, we can drive a real car, a GMC, if we really want to. not actual gameplay footage, then what's the point? What's the point? Mighty No. 9 and others have soured me on semi-abandoned game property, but indie. This one seems a bit more promising, though, as far as, like, not just being a complete, scam at launch kind of thing. It looks like a finished game, I'll put it that way. but I guess, I don't know, Mighty No. 9, I guess, looked like that as well. Yeah, I don't know. I'll probably wait for like initial responses to it. Just like you. But it does look interesting.
Eager to see what's next. I am Stefan Bollet, creative director of the crew.
I think I had Jet Set Radio on the Vita. Think? I'm trying to remember.
Today, at last.
I think it was ported there.
To introduce the future of the crew.
If so, I need to figure out how to play stuff from the Vita.
A celebration for car lovers to share
the crew, okay. It's the crew. Air car game.
In a way, no matter how you enjoy cars and driving.
Wink.
On your own or with your crew. Motorfest has something.
Yeah, there's a Vita version. Okay, that's probably where I got it then.
Motorfest.
I did have a lot of random stuff on the Vita.
You choose how you like to have.
Yeah, I don't know how you capture it outside of using a PSTV. Maybe I should look into that. I think there's a way to like root your Vita or something. At least that's the term that I've heard for that. Maybe able to like you just plug it in. But I don't know. I don't know if I trust modding my system like that. I'm just afraid I'm gonna break it. And I won't even have a Vita.
Dive into a legacy of the world's most influential automakers.
Whee. Made in Japan.
The night street racing scene.
Japanese. Furious drift, 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 drift.
Unleash the cutting edge power of electric supercars.
Oh boy.
And this is just a taste. For the first time ever, we leave the US mainland behind. Our festival has landed in one of the most breathtaking and vibrant places on Earth, Oahu. Let's find out why Oahu.
Oh boy, everyone's airdropping their cars to Oahu.
Race through the city street of Honolulu.
Is there a Capcom showcase? Yeah, that's at 3 Pacific, I believe.
Into lush rainforest.
Yeah, 3 p.m. So it'll probably be a little gap. I'll do a couple things, and then I'll probably also be playing some Zelda in between, because I don't think this is going to be another like 4 hours.
Goes for a profusion of vehicles. Choose and customize your ride.
Yeah, that one's probably going to be a bit more fun. I think that'll have some interesting games to show. Oh boy, a Toyota!
Present and future.
Porsche.
Recognize the latest from
Porsche.
I think so, yeah. I know. You are as thrilled as I am.
Praying for Mega Man. We can hope. Beauty. Ah, the Lambo. Here, you know, just take a photo of me with that. I've got a Lambo for sure. I'm rich. No.
You will be able to import your vehicle collection.
And just become one of those like Instagram influencers. For free. You know, there's another way you can play it for free. I'm kidding.
Ugh. Our summer showcase. Since the beginning of the year, thousands of players have tested the game and given us priceless
feedback. Going back to talking about pirates from earlier. I'll shut up. I'm a terrible long live piracy. Yeah. Exactly.
From the entire team at Ubisoft, Ivory Tower. Mahalo. Thank you.
Mahalo.
Motorfest.
Aloha. In-engine 4K footage. Wow, that car can be places. I don't know. I just like kart racers. Neko, how you doing? We're having a good day. We're watching Ubisoft right now. There's a Capcom one later today too, and I'm probably just gonna be doing some like Zelda in between. But yeah, hope you're having a good day. Feel free to hang out, chill, watch with us. Oh, heck yeah, all the cars. Anything good so far? Nothing particularly striking from Ubisoft, but it's funny to watch more so. They talked about Avatar, they've talked about, they have that pirate game coming out, they got this, they got that, the Mario and Rabbids game. Yeah, they had Mario Rabbids DLC. Yeah, that's about the most, like, relevant thing for me. They had another, like, anime Yu-Gi-Oh! Looking rabid and stuff. That's exciting. But yeah, I don't know. I just like, it's not that I like making fun of, but at the same time, like, I just got a dorky stage show usually, and it's fun to watch for that, if nothing else. September 14th, we can finally have our driver's license. Oh yeah, and then just our radio characters in some other game, which I thought they had just at radio for a second. I was so excited for a moment. Oh boy. Ah yes, I too have mine set up on a very nice little stand instead of just on the table. Oh boy. We can murder poor peasants in the... Mine is totally not on the floor, I know, right? Mine frequently is on the floor. It's okay. Ah yes. I'm definitely gonna be going full motion with this and then I'm gonna smack into the wall. I mean, sure. The only problem with having things be like a quest exclusive is that like the only way to capture them if you're gonna like do anything with it is like the link, which isn't great. Gonna knock a drink over with style. Heck yeah. Aw, yeah, I beat up so many people. Putting peasants back in like the 1700s or something. 1900s? Probably 1800s. Yeah. Anyway, Nexus VR.
Hi everyone. I hope you enjoy.
I'll do a cool backflip.
It's exciting new way.
These peasants know they deserved it. Obviously, they were with the what is it that he's fighting? The Syndicate? No, not the Syndicate.
Fight and be stealthy. In new memories from three legendary assassins, Ezio, Cassandra, and Connor. I cannot wait to see
your boy
feel the thrill of virtual reality in the Assassin's Creed universe. But there is more. Nexus
There's more.
Is the only game that will offer new ways to play Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed could
Someone's getting mic'd up.
First open world RPG game
I think.
It will take you to ancient China in a time of intrigue and conspiracy. In this brand new adventure, you'll experience the icon
tonight, I made a little
for free, anywhere,
hair bow and bone out of needle felting for B because I can. Why not? I had some extra stuff. the bow just fell into my cereal bowl. Luckily, there isn't much in it, but it's unfortunate. Rip.
Legacy.
Hopefully, it just doesn't smell. That's the main thing. Legacy. Assassin's Creed China. Are we really doing okay? Assassin's Creed China time.
For all to see. That inheritance of knowledge helps to guide and shape our future. Now it's your turn. To build on those foundations and rise to even greater heights.
To step rise.
And into a vast world. To make your own legacy.
Oh boy. Work in progress. I mean, sure, they were gonna do it eventually. Oh, of course it's Jade. Of course. I like how the birds were moving, but he was completely still.
We've all been waiting for this moment.
All of us.
It's a very special game. Designed as an homage to the first titles of the series that many
Wait, Mirage?
Coming October 12th, Assassin's Creed Mirage takes the franchise back to its roots. Sarah, our narrative director for the game, will come on stage to tell you more about Basim and his journey. But before that,
okay, Mirage is a different one than what they just showed. Oh, Mirage is the remake of one. Or something related to one. Yeah, head empty. Ouch. Ouch, falling into water from that high up. Ah yes. It's indie hipster singer. Avocados and bananas.
The feathers of the head were dipped in the blood of the target.
How do you know that?
The feathers forge our paths, remind us of who we are, who we can be.
The Order has held dominion over men and their empires for centuries. Strike quickly.
Yes, the Order.
Swallow your questions, serve without complaint. Who is she to tell you when to strike?
It wasn't empty enough, exactly. Serving others isn't what most people consider freedom, to be fair.
To walk the shadows broken, pour your pain into the brotherhood.
We are messengers.
Completely lost on the plot of Assassin's Creed, haven't played it since before. Never really played it. I've watched some people play it back in the day, but yeah, like, I have no idea what's going on. I just know that, like, you're also a person in the modern day, but they never show that. Or at least you were at one point, they might not be anymore. I've gone past it. Early on, it was Assassin's good, Templars bad. That's right, Templars. I think it's somewhat shifted. I see, it was... the Templars weren't the baddie all along or something, who knows. But what if the bad guy isn't all bad?
What does it mean to be free? What must be sacrificed in the quest for freedom and justice the hidden ones fiercely pursue? How can you find your path and fulfill your destiny when you don't know who you are?
What did it cost? everything.
As he grows from street thief to master assassin, Basim thinks he has found a sense of purpose as a hidden one, working in the dark to serve the light. But his nightmarish visions keep haunting him, leading to more questions with no answer. In Baghdad, seeking the...
Like, all the weapons are just, like, shining. look at all my weapons.
One of the richest, most diverse, and most advanced...
Available October 12.
...is a turning point of its history. Unrest is growing, seeding a revolution against corruption and arbitrary justice, an uprising that will turn the tides of history and change the lives of everyone. Childhood friends,
everyone's lives,
as well as newly formed allies and enemies, will shape Basim's adventure. But his horrific visions are the face of a struggle that he can only handle alone. There is a lot to look forward to in Assassin's Creed
Basim.
To make you understand our unique Back to the Roots experience is to show you the game. In the following gameplay walkthrough, we meet Basim right after the assassination of his first main target, as he reports back to Roshan...
Hey, spoilers. I'm kidding.
Enjoy.
In-game 4K capture has been edited for time. You know, okay. My settings. The highest we can go is, wow, 1078, not even 1080 technically. That's the source. So like, even if you're capturing it in 4K, like it's not showing up to us as 4K. So funny. So funny that it's specifically 1078 instead of 1080. Oh well. Riff Raff, Street Rat! Scoundrel, take that! He's got no aim.
Alhamdulillah. I am glad you are safe.
Alhamdulillah, a first of many achievements to come, Basim.
We should only hope. There's still much work to do.
Got that deep voice.
And our focus was on Al-Ghul. Fulav quietly scouted the city for where we could erect more bureaus.
I have found dwellings in three districts that are most unassuming. Ibid and Rebecca have arrived from Alamut and set off to Al Abbasiyah and Karh. I will make my way to Sharqiya shortly.
And I will
Shakira
in Karh, where corruption is as common as the arid air. Fire about some things he's been working on. Then come find us.
So I guess this is kind of like a
Have a look, Basim.
In tandem with the first one, I guess. Unlock a new tool. I got them blow darts.
Resourceful as always. My thanks, Abu Ja'far.
Ah yes, I gained so much information from those depictions. Nah. Yes, you can pretend that there's info on the back. Do not take any damage. Is one of the things. It's all that I saw. Imagine having the leg strength to squat on like an orb like that. Couldn't be me.
This is the place.
I can barely do any cool squat.
Consider the approach.
No, it's gonna be like, what the heck? Okay, but like... Dude, and there's like, I hate birds. Ah, yes. Don't look suspicious. Don't look suspicious. Don't be suspicious. Don't be suspicious. Yeah. Blending in great there, dude. In the booty. Oh sure, one dude goes to sleep and this guy gets killed. Wow. I see how it is. Picking favorites. Noisemaker. Yeah. I totally didn't see that arm shooting up out of the flowers in my field of view. Oh no! It's just so funny how some things you have to just kind of like ignore for the sake of video games. Ouch. The bird hater has been murdered. Something to appreciate, I guess. Never had you try to be non-lethal, always just go wild. Yeah. Yeah. Whatchamacallit. It's like sneaking around, but it's not like no kill runs kind of thing. I think Hitman does crazy stuff like that, where like you get... Or where you can be, like, entirely non-lethal, whereas this one's just like, yeah, you're probably gonna have to fight some stuff eventually, but, like, just have fun with it. Eh? Oh no, he stole his stomach! Oh no, he stabbed him, that's what he did. But it just looked like he went, like, grab the stomach and then let go. I'm here! What? No boy. How did that one dude chilling over there? Oh, he was looking the other way, I guess? Cool. That's ranking in him and it's not killing anyone but the target and never being detected. Yeah. Yeah, that one... I know you can do it anyway, but... Yeah, the way that they want you to do it and get the best score is like the no detection kind of stuff. Which is cool. But very painful to do, I'm sure. Just fell down and murdered someone and yet... Sure, you know, make friends with everyone by pushing them out of the way. Cool, yeah, uh-huh. Mirage. My rage. Me. Rage. All the rage. I'm angry. No. Like, they seem to be moving away from the RPG elements they had in recent games. It's possible they're only doing it for this one because it's more based on the original one, but who knows? We'll see. Pepper, we're raging together.
It's thanks to you that we are here today. You are at the heart of everything we do.
And to all right, tiny hands, man.
Teams around the world as well, I would like to say a big thank you. Your talent and passion are at the foundation of this fantastic lineup.
No. Not to get dark, but Ubisoft has also, kind of like Blizzard, brushed a lot of accusations under the rug. So, I don't know. I watched Ubisoft stuff, like, I don't know. Ubisoft properties, they don't really grab me in the first place, so it's not like they'd really be, like, quote-unquote, losing my business. But, like, I don't know. They do some stupids. More than stupids, some bads. Outlaws. I haven't had any need to play games in recent history.
Alright, let's get over the speech and let's get to the gameplay.
Ha 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 ha.
Star Wars Outlaws takes place in a time of great civil unrest across the galaxy. For some, this is a time of turmoil. For outlaws, this is a time of opportunity. As a cunning thief, Kay Vess and her companion Nyx fight for survival.
I do like that little axolotl creature. What are his pants? They're those like drop crotch ones, the harem pants. They look comfy, but at the same time, yeah, they're kind of interesting in like a business presentation setting for sure. But I think a lot of people on the stage, I mean, that one guy before for the Blood Dragon was wearing a very like interesting techie outfit. I have a feeling it might have been like Off-White, the brand. And then, like, attack all those. They get caught on stuff a lot. Oh, yeah, I'm sure if you're, like, walking over something, it's very inconvenient. But, you know, you gotta give room to breathe. I'm kidding. Just wear a skirt. Kidding. That little, like, red panda on that hat, that's kind of cute. It might be, like, their company logo, though.
Canix's journey will take them across the galaxy through stunning, varied.
Yeah, I don't know. Fashion is weird. Skirt would look better. It would give the same effect without being like, huh?
A moon that features windswept savanna.
I mean, I guess some people would be like, huh? It's, I guess those pants are for people who want to wear skirts but don't have the confidence for it.
City of Miragana.
So mean.
Hive of scum and villainy.
Scum and villainy, my two favorite things.
Will encounter several criminal syndicates that learn.
I just want like a
is measured in the value of influence, reputation.
Yeah, would be nice if skirts were more acceptable for guys to wear. Seem more suited for them. Honestly, like the amount that like some like cis guys complain about, like, oh man, you know. You gotta, you know, like, the quote-unquote man-spreading and stuff like that. Like, you gotta let the balls breathe. Just wear a skirt, my guy. Just wear a skirt. You'll get what you need, what you want. But yeah, honestly, degender clothing. Let everyone wear what they want.
If you're willing to take the risk, the galaxy.
I just want a plush of that little axolotl creature.
Thank you.
I am sure they'll have some kind of little merch of it. If they don't, they're missing an opportunity. Powered by Snowdrop. Ah, yes, the classic. Unobtainium. Look at this little guy. Look at this little guy. Aww. It's the next Baby Yoda. I'm sure they're pinning their hopes on that.
Alright, Nix. Let's go get paid.
Did you pick up the thing? Ah, yes. ish. You kinda hurt your hand in the process, but sure. I love how they always talk about pertinent things. No, don't put baby in harm's way. No one sees the creature pressing the button. Sure.
Nice one.
Sure.
Hang on tight, little buddy.
This is kind of hilarious. So much noise. Cool. Didn't even look before you moved. McClunky. Ow! That was pure metal. Pretty sure she shot first there, I know, right?
Hey, Nick.
She's the one that said McClunky.
This is getting bad.
There's a lot of enemies. She shot first and she snapped her neck to avoid it. Ah, yeah. Okay. I thought she said something else for a second, but it was fake swears.
I think that went pretty well, right?
So well. Yeah. Nice. Whee! Ouch. Turns into that one motorcycle scene from Advent Children. And did it go? We don't know what her goal was, so maybe it actually did. I mean, I think she grabbed the little jewel thingy. The little creature grabbed it and brought it to her, but then it just, I don't know if she picked it up from the ground where it left it. Did you forget it, my girl? Reputation down. Oh no. Oh no. Our thief clout is excuse me? What? They're just like, yeah, we're just gonna keep going. Okay. Sure. I kind of gave up pretty quick.
You're late, Kay. Danka's waiting.
What?
Danka.
No.
Okay.
No, but you're dry.
What?
Be careful. Danka's a broker, not a friend. She can't be trusted.
Can out here. See you back at the ship.
Oh boy. Oh heck yeah, beaded curtain. Classic. And not outstanding, but a good robot, yeah.
I still like my odds. K-Vess. Back already. I told you she's fresh, but she's good. Who's this? Just a friend.
Sus.
Job
grab was more complicated than you said, Danka.
Okay, she did grab it. Oh.
They're investments.
It's salmon eggs.
Wait. We haven't met. Don't really know many of you. Stealing illegal contraband, running.
Yeah, you know they're evil because they slapped your axolotl. Exactly. Only evil people bop the axolotl. Bribe, do not bribe.
Thanks, but I'm smart enough to get myself out of trouble. You pay the tax just like everyone else.
Whoa, kid, let's just relax.
You won't make it off to Shara alive. Maybe.
You pay the tax. The cheese tax. That's some janky hair. At least in that one shot, but also, I don't know, does it really matter that much? I think it's just when they try to make it look good, and then it looks jank. Whereas if you know it's gonna be jank, can you just live with it? Kind of thing. Oh man, booking it to the ship.
We need to leave.
Yeah, no kidding.
Indeed. Kind of interesting just how long that they're focusing on some of these. It's been a good little bit of Star Wars. And also, they did like 20 minutes of Avatar at the start. I think I sense a pattern. Big IPs get like 20 minutes, even though like I don't want that much. Maybe some people do. Someone I'm sure is, you know, super hyped about Star Wars. I'm neutral. It looks solid. Yeah, yes. Gonna do a cool, you know, the smugglers run in, 5 parsecs. Or whatever. Wee! Calibrating. Goodbye. How does anyone chase anyone in this universe? I guess if they're able to lock your coordinates. Escape the Empire, check. Made yourself a wanted fugitive for 2,500 credits, SMH. It's truly not a good deal. Ooh. Should you really be letting it eat that? What if it like explodes?
Anywhere we want.
The heck even is that thing? Okay. 2,500 credits and an axolotl chew toy. They're going to Avatar Land. No. McClunky. I want to know what the purple orbs are, then the axolotl, the best thing I've seen here. I know, that axolotl is kind of what's making this interesting to me. I just like seeing it. It's cute. But yeah, that purple orb, like, what the heck is it? Is it just, like, salmon roe? Is it caviar? It's probably it's either gonna be something integral to the plot that turns out to be like the big device, or it's gonna be absolutely useless. One of the two. Thank you. Yay! Oh, I see one thing, one thing. Get that connected. Connect here. Please recognize these famous people. Hey, there you go, that guy. The tech suit. Look at us all together. COVID, distancing be darned. Whatever. I know we're technically past that by government regulation standards. It still paranoids me whenever people are like super crammed together though. They did it. Well, love the commitment on the tech suit guy, I know, right? He really went in. Alright, and then this is just this stuff. Alrighty. We don't need to see that. Good job, good job. It was very Ubisoft, I'll put it that way. I might cut the VOD a whole lot of nothing. Someone, I'm sure, is happy with that stuff. Just, I don't know. I feel like I'm not, like, the target audience of a lot of video game stuff. Which is weird, because, like, I play a lot of video games, but, like, I don't know. Got those weird specific tastes. And unfortunately, a lot of AAA is not that. Good 10 minutes of good content in that last hour and a half. Yeah, it's definitely, like, nuggets of good in between, nuggets of, not nuggets, but, a lot of, a pretty wrapping. Shiny stuff that gets them the news article headlines kind of thing. But yeah, I think I'm gonna cut the VOD here, but I'll be, like, right back. I'm just gonna, just so that I can export this bit. Yeah, I'll see you in just a second. Maybe we're probably gonna play some Zelda or something for a bit. Why not? Yeah. All right, BRB.